Now we are going to see the problem on single row deep groove ball bearing. Let us see that problem. A single row deep groove ball bearing is subjected to a radial force of 8 kilonewtons and thrust force of 3 kilonewtons. The shaft rotates at 1200 rpm. The expected rating life is 20,000 hours. The minimum acceptable diameter of the shaft is 75 mm. Select a suitable ball bearing for this application. So let us see the solution. The given data, radial force is given as 8 kilonewtons. Let us take Fr as a notation for radial force, 8 kilonewtons, and thrust force is given 3 kilonewtons. Thrust force is also called axial force. So let us take Fa is a notation, 3 kilonewtons, and speed is given 1200 rpm. So let us take n is equals to 1200 rpm, and rating life of the bearing is given in the hours. So that is, let us take LH, 20,000 hours, and the diameter of the shaft is given d, let us take small d, 75 mm, which is also nothing but bore of the bearing. So you can see here this shaft is inserted from this bore, so which will be same as 75 mm. So bore here also, bore also 75 mm. So now, so here he is asking to select a suitable ball bearing. So the selection of bearing will depends upon the dynamic C value, which is called dynamic load capacity or dynamic load rating. So let us see how to find out this C value. This C will get from the formula, this rating life formula, that is L is equals to C by F whole to the power of K into 10 to the power of 6 revolutions. So this L is given in the hours, that can be converted into revolutions, and you can substitute here. And also this F can be found out, this formula F is equals to X into V into Fr plus Y into Fa. So here X is called radial load factor, Y is called axial load factor, and V is called rotation factor. Rotation factor means when the inner ring is rotating, you have to take rotation factor as 1. When outer ring is rotating, you have to take that factor as 1.2. And Fr and Fa values are given in the question. And to find out this equivalent load F, we have to find out X and Y values. So this X and Y values will depends upon these two ratios, Fa by C naught and Fa by Fr. So this, when you find this X and Y values from this, depending upon the these two ratios, you can substitute here and you can find out F. So to find out this Fa by C naught ratio, you require C naught value. So that C naught is selected it is selected against a bearing series. So you have basically for this given single row deep groove ball bearing, you have four series for the bearings in general. So when you see 0 for extra light series, 2 for light series, 3 for medium, and 4 stands for heavy series. And this single row deep groove ball bearings for the against this series, I have given some diagram here. This inside diameter bore is same, but when the series is changing, external diameter is changing, and also width of the bearings are changing. So when you increase the series, means it is having more load carrying capacity. So here initially for the given applications, this C naught is selected by selecting a series of the bearing. So and this is this procedure will be like a trial and error. So you have to go for 60, 62, 63, 64. So let us start with 60 or 62. I am starting with the 62 series. We can start, friends, we can start with 60 series also, but there you have to find out C, and that C is compared. So but I am starting here with 62 series. Let us check that 62 series and find out C value, capital C value. So first of all, for this 6215, here 2 stands for light series I have told, and 6 for the single row deep groove ball bearing. Actually it is a 2 series, if you say, or simply 62 series. For that let us find out C naught, that is from the data book. If you see here 6215, so why only 15 means shaft diameter is given 75, so against that the number is 6215. So against that, if you see the static load capacity, C naught is given 41,385. Substitute that 41,385 here to find out this Fa by C naught ratio, you will get 0.07. And also find out Fa by Fr ratio, 3 kilonewtons, that is 3000 newtons, Fr 8 kilonewtons, 8000 newtons. When you simplify that, you will get 0.37. So Again, is this FA by C naught ratio you got, we got 0.07. Again, that you have to select E value from the data book. So, if you see here, we got FA by C naught ratio 0.07. Against that, if you see, this E value is 0.27, and also FA by FR we got 0.37. So here we have to find out X and Y values. FA by FR we got 0.37, and here the E value is 0.27. So since FA by FR is greater than E, that is 0.37 is greater than this 0.27. So this X value will be here. You have to select X and Y values from these rows because FA by FR is greater than E. So, against this 0.07 and 0.27, the X value will be 0.56 and Y value will be 1.6. That you have to substitute in this formula. So, X 0.56, Y 1.6. Substitute in the equivalent load formula, and I told V is the rotation factor which is taken as 1 when inner race is rotating. So, in the problem, nothing is given, inner race is rotating or outer race is rotating. So, let us assume in general inner race will be rotating, for which V value will be taken as 1. So, here V is 1, X we got 0.56 and Y we got 1.6 from the data book. When you substitute in this equivalent load, you will get, and when you simplify that, you will get equivalent load F is 9280 newtons. So, this is substituted in the rating life formula. From that you can find out this C, that is dynamic capacity. So, before substituting here, this L is given in the equation hours, that should be substituted in the revolution, because this formula, rating life formula, is given, I have given here this in the revolutions. So, this hours is converted into revolutions with this relation. L is equals to 60 into N into LH. N is RPM, LH is the hours, rating life in hours. So, when you substitute in this relation, that rating life will get 1440 into 10 to the power of 6 revolutions. So, substitute that in this formula. So, here from this we require C, dynamic capacity. So, when you rearrange the formula will be like this. Substitute L value and F value, which you got 9280, and when you simplify, you are getting that the dynamic capacity C as 1,4793.77 newtons. But friends, when you see from the data book, the selected series is 6215 series, for which the dynamic capacity is 50,600. When you see here, 6215, for which dynamic capacity is 50,600, but we got that as 1,4,000 some value. So, this 6215 series is not suitable for this application. So, let us go for next series, that is 63 series. So, here when you choose 6315, from that once again you have to choose C naught value from the data book. So, when you see here, 6315 and 75 is the shaft diameter against which the C naught value is 71,100. So, when you substitute in this FA by C naught ratio, you are getting this FA by C naught ratio as 0.04 and FA by FR already calculated 0.37. So, let us find out E against this FA by C naught ratio. So, we got FA by C naught 0.04. Against that, if you see here, FA is 0.04, the E value will be 0.24. And here also, this FA by FR 0.37 is, you are getting more than this E value. So, X and Y values are selected from these two ratios, against 0.04, means here X value will become 0.56, Y value will become 1.8. So, when you substitute the X is 0.56 and Y 1.8 in this equivalent load formula, you are getting equivalent load as 9880 newtons. Substitute in this C formula, when you simplify it, you are getting 1,11,569.23 newtons. But when you see from the data book for the 6315 series, the dynamic capacity C will be 89,280 newtons. But we got in the calculations 1,11,000 something. So this bearing is also not suitable for this application. So let us go for the next series, that is 6415 series. So friends, when you go for the next series, that is 6415 series, for that the C naught value is also taken from the data book. If you see here, or 6415, the T0 value is 1,600 newtons. Substitute in this Fa by C0 ratio and simplify, you are getting is Fa by C0 ratio as 0.02 and Fa by Fr already calculated 0.37. Against this Fa by C0, that is 0.02, find out E value from the data book, that is 0.02 here, the E value is 0.22. So this Fa by Fr here also more than the E, so X and Y values are taken from these two columns. Again, is this Fa by C0 0.02, the X value will be 0.56 and Y value will be 2 here. And when you substitute here, X is 0.56, Y is 2, in this equivalent load formula, you are getting equivalent load as 10,480 newtons. So that is substituted in this C formula. When you solve what C, that is you are getting 1,18,344.69 newtons. But when you see from the data book, the for 6415 series, the C capacity from the data book is 1,20,000. When you see here 6415 C, dynamic capacity C is 1,20,000 for 6415, but you got only 1,18,000. So this 6415 will be suitable for this application. So friends, for more videos, please subscribe and activate bell symbol. Thank you.